to me. If you betrayed her, if any harm comes to her, I will kill you myself.
Hey, welcome back, lads. The new Zombies trailer is absolutely insane and has given us a ton of new story and gameplay details, which is hidden in every frame, so we're gonna look at that in depth today. There is so much going on in the trailer that it might be easy to miss a couple of things, right? Like, the scene where Samantha is captured seems to be from an intro cutscene which is unreleased, because it's definitely not gameplay, and also, she is literally sucked into the dark ether. Perhaps by the big giant creature. Yep, this thing is back from D Machina, but this time we're actually gonna fight it at the end of the Easter egg quest, where it shoots a laser out of its hole. Now, the difference is when the operators go through the portal, they just end up at Outpost 25, but Samantha seems to have been taken by the creature itself and is being corrupt by the dark ether. That's why you see that happening. It's changing her in the poster image we got. That's why they are saying we need to save her before time runs out, because she's in the process of being corrupted. We have a shot here which gives us a good look at the map, like this kind of open courtyard with a crashed heli in it, which should be a nice training spot. We also see the map is kind of surrounded by this kind of blue or purple dark ether. I don't know, what would you call it, like, bubble? Sure, dark ether bubble. I'm not really sure what this blue cylindrical machine is, but it's definitely eye-catching. Maybe it's just a part of this dark ether crystal reactor or generator we see. So there's about three of these across the map, and it's basically just power, so you need to power up different parts of the map. Hopefully that's not too much of a pain in the ass, but it's not going to be a simple power switch. Another nice look at the kind of purple vibe or ether bubble, and also this kind of trench area. Now, the new Wonder Weapon is literally like an upgraded kind of AK-47, and I think this might be the Ray rifle or Ray gun rifle, which was leaked before Cold War even released, and here it is, finally. I mean, that does make sense if this map was actually, right, Vietnam Zombies was supposed to be here at the start of the game, but now it's DLC 1. It also seems to have some blast anti or anti-gravity kind of thing, and talking about that, there is also this pad which flings or launches you, just like Der Wundersphere's from the Black Ops 3 map Der Eisendrache. Right, it's a lot of German stuff, and ever since this map has been teased to us, we've noticed a lot of similarities between these two maps, right? Firebase Z and Der Eisendrache, and a couple of days ago I had an entire video looking at all the connections, how they seem to be similar and like have parallels, and here you go, just another one. Another mini boss or special zombie here is the Russian Mangler, which is also literally from Black Ops 3, the map Grodkrovy or City of Blood. It has a launcher to hit you from range, and also this claw made out of sickles or scythes. Damn, how Soviet can you get? But I really hope they're not overdoing it with special zombies, because that definitely can happen. And finally here, the storyline is jumping into some interesting stuff, because this also seems to be from a cutscene, whether it's for intro or ending. I doubt they would show us an ending cutscene already, if there even is one. So I'm hoping they do release this cutscene soon, but yeah, it's about this Ravanov guy, right, Sergei Raganov or whatever he's called, basically being the insider for Samantha but betrays her, and then Weaver is threatening him. Cool. In the teaser images, Samantha was receiving intel from someone called, or their initial is R. We all thought it was Richtofen, but now it is, it's Ravanov, and now we get a look at him in game. He's definitely this guy in the poster as well.
If you